Men det at skære i et barn uden grund, det sætter altså et aftryk, som munder ud i spørgsmålet, hvorfor gjorde I det, mor?
So I regret my choice of circumcising. The regret is deeper and more difficult and more painful to overcome than anything else I've ever really done in my life. And I really believe it comes from not protecting my son. I allowed him to be cut. I made a choice that can't be corrected or changed. He was born perfect and beautiful, and I cut the most sensitive part of his body.
When my son was born in 1983, and we were at a Harvard hospital, and a physician came into the room and asked, have you decided whether to have your son circumcised yet or not? And this was a very odd question because my wife and I had never even considered it. And then my wife's a physician, so I looked to her to give some input, but she'd given birth the day before on medications and was tired and nursing. And in retrospect, she was, in my opinion, legally incapacitated. So then the doctor launched into what Bob Van Hau calls the talk, where the doctor said at the time, based on the AAP's position, then in effect that circumcision reduced the risk of urinary tract infections, penile cancer, and some sexually transmitted diseases. So it had potential medical benefits. But then interestingly, he said, but that's not a medical justification for it. And he said, because urinary tract infections can be treated by antibiotics, penile cancer is rare and occurs in old age, and circumcision cannot responsibly be viewed as protecting against sexually transmitted diseases. So then I was thinking, well, all right, then the answer is no. So then he started saying, well, would you like to have your son circumcised for religious reasons? I said, well, what do you mean? I'm not religious. And then he said, well, some people have their son circumcised for religious reasons. I was thinking, well, I don't care about religious reasons. Why? What's that got to do with my son? So then he said, well, some people, circumcise their son for cultural reasons. I'm thinking, well, that sounds stupid. I mean, this is a medical thing. You're a doctor. Why would we do that?
Well, I'm a nurse, and I worked in labor and delivery. So I've probably seen thousands of circumcisions. I held the baby boys down. And at the time that I did that, I didn't give it a second thought. It was what we thought was the right thing to do, and it was just everyone was doing it. When you know better, you do better, and I didn't know better at that time.
I've done hundreds of circumcisions, and I regret every one.
I'm a Jew, and I was raised religious, and I thought that was just something Jews did to their babies. I was very, very sad to find out exactly what circumcision is. I didn't realize how much was being cut. I didn't know anything about the foreskin. I've learned, I've educated myself, and I think it's wrong to circumcise children for any reason whatsoever.
Most Jews don't realize that in biblical times, circumcision involved cutting the foreskin that extended beyond the glands. It was not a full ripping away of the foreskin. Not that that's okay, but it's very different from what has been done since Hellenic times, when the rabbis were very disturbed that some Jewish men were stretching and tying their foreskins because they were being ridiculed by the Greeks who were in that area at the time. And so then they commanded that the new circumcision had to be perea, was a full reaming of the glands and cutting away of the foreskin. And that's living tissue. I was told that that wasn't. And I don't know how anyone who can witness a baby experiencing this cannot understand that this is excruciating pain.
It's painful. It's abusive. It's traumatic. And if anybody who's not in a covenant does it, I think they should be put in prison. I don't think anybody has an excuse for mutilating a child. depriving them of their glans, penis, and all. I mean, it's the, you know, we don't have rights to other people's bodies, and a baby needs to have its rights protected. I think anybody who circumcises a baby, right, is an abuser. Doesn't matter, unless it's like absolutely medically advised because of some complication that you know, urologist says this baby has to be circumcised. Otherwise, what for?
I had a neighbor who knew I was Jewish and came up to me very proud that she had taken her child to a Jewish doctor to be circumcised, and I just said, why?
I am a Jew, and I question circumcision. I've been questioning circumcision ever since I learned of the rite as a girl. At that time, I questioned circumcision because it seemed wrong to cause pain to infants, and because it seemed strange to surgically alter a healthy, God-given part of the body. As I grew into adulthood, I added questions. I continue to add them. I question circumcision because of its risks. I question it because it is seen by many as a perfunctory act rather than a spiritual one. I question it because it seems to require parents to take advantage of their infant's dependence and weakness. And I question it because of the paradox that those who support infant circumcision often cringe at the idea of circumcision of an older child as a puberty rite.
I address my comments mostly to the Jewish community. As a Jew and a psychologist, I understand the stress that religious communities feel in connection with questioning of circumcision. I raise such questions with the awareness that they may evoke a range of feelings. I empathize and respect these feelings, and also acknowledge the profound place that circumcision has in Judaism. However, I raise these questions out of deep caring and compassion for our community generally, and our male infants in particular.
Ich bin Humanist, ich bin Atheist, ich bin auch Jude, das ist natürlich wahr. Und sie haben alle so viele Eigenschaften, aber diese Beschneidung ist für mich wirklich barbarisch und ich kann es nicht dulden, dass kleine Babys oder kleine Kinder einfach diese grausame Operation erleben müssen.
I am what's called a secular Jew. Or an ethnic Jew. I am a Jew by ethnic origin. I'm a Jew by birth. It's been there since approximately 500 BCE, instituted by priests. That's another subject, but it was instituted by priests as a symbol of loyalty to the theocracy that they were creating. So it has been part of Jewish culture for something like 2,500 years, but it has changed over time. The procedure itself has changed over time, and certainly we know that Judaism as a religion has changed immensely over time. There's no reason why we can't get rid, at least why many of us anyway, can't get rid of this abominable custom.